instead of one, it is many, featuring Helper. Not actually Helper, more like Cousin.
More like Dead Weight.
Dead Weight. Dead Weight. Roll it. Come here. POV footage. I'm gonna grab the blower and the battery blower and the battery trimmer. I'll show you which yard. We gotta go through the alley to get to it. Give me just a second. This is the kind of stuff you normally don't see on these videos. You don't need this. Going to cut a backyard really quick. It's going to be a little bit overgrown. But it is what it is. This was a yard on last Monday's schedule. Unfortunately, on Monday, we were still in the hospital with our son's birth. We weren't released until the afternoon. And then it rained for 2.5 days, so we didn't get to it till here it is Saturday. Hit this part here too. Gate should be unlocked. Yeah, there it is. We'll set this here. All right. Four bars. Yeah, I told you it'd be kind of bad. If it bogs down, you'll have to kind of clean it up and clean out underneath it and whatnot to get it. Right now, it's just cut it. The point is just to cut it down, and then we're coming in the following Monday to get it back on the biweekly schedule. Because all that rain and over 2 weeks of growth, this is what you get. Yeah, there shouldn't be any debris, but there is some dog crap, so you got to watch out for that. What do the people want?
More dead weight.
overgrown grass cutting footage is what the people want. Gotta hit this easement. I had to do the walk of shame, unfortunately, and get more line. Stupid walk of shame here. Look at this bloody easement. Man, it's overgrown. All right. Set this phone here. We'll see what we can get. That may not work. That may or may not work. Screw it. Just sit on the ground. I don't care. Just this little strip to edge here, and then this little island here. Cousin Caleb's first experience with battery powered tools. Hold that Darwin grip, you won't have to lean over. There you go.
Getting it done, yes sir.
About to get on the Vantage and cut this one real quick.
Ooh man, wild.
How bad?
Dangerous move, but it worked. So tell us, Caleb, tell the people, what do you think of your first experience with battery powered trimmers and edgers?
You want my honest opinion?
Give me your honest opinion.
Inconsistent power supply.
What?
I prefer the more consistent of gasoline. But
he didn't have it on. He didn't have it on two or three either. He only had it on one.
I actually think the battery maybe almost dead. Honestly.
Really? No, it says 3 bars. To be honest, the one that's connected to the trimmer, it got rained on, and after that, it's kind of had this intermittent cutout issue.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Ever since it got rained on, I had those trimmer covers on them, on the edger and the trimmer, and I got caught in a downpour, and I was on the other side of the church property, so it's not like I could run back and put them in the cab.
I'm gonna cover that window up a little bit.
It's not like I could run back into the cab and put them in there, but what happened was one of them was slightly staggered off to the other one on the rack there. So all the water pooled up on the top and it drained onto the bottom one, and it got it saturated the tool. And it dried out and everything worked perfectly, but at least for a while. But then it started, a couple days later, it started to do that. Huh. And it's been that way ever since. It still operates. It's just, it's that little bit of a caveat with it.
Is it the weed eater itself or the battery?
It's the weed eater itself, because multiple batteries, you can change battery and it does the same exact thing. It's only when you like try to feather it a little bit. Like if you try to feather it, release the throttle and have it be like 1% or 5 or 10% or something like that.
Ooh.
The running it at full throttle, it does fine. And the edger, the other one that's connected to the edger, doesn't have that issue.
Huh.
It did because it got all the water drained off of it. Don't leave your tools in the rain.
Yeah.
No, that's actually the reason I got combis, is so they can be taken apart and put in the cab when it's raining. And every other time I've been able to do that, but when you're on the other side of the property and it's a down and you're in the middle of a downpour, there's nothing you can do. So anyway, Caleb does not like the battery powered tools.
Well, maybe I haven't had a fair shot.
We will have to chastise him for this later. Maybe he hasn't had a fair shot. Maybe life wasn't fair to him.
Oh,
okay. Life was not fair to you, sir.
Inconsistent power level. What the heck is he talking about? I think their power level is just great. But I will admit, there is a learning curve to the battery powered trimmer. It's not exactly the same as operating a gas powered one. Now I got the BR800 here. Be the only one we bagged today, luckily. Bradford pear trees over here. Yeah, it's just this little strip right over here and then one by behind the fence.
Okay.
Yeah. Backyard looks great. Wow. All right. Like that. This day is done with a wrap up at Chick-fil-A for lunch. Look at all this food we got to eat, both of us, between the two of us. When you work for a living, you tend to work up an appetite, let me tell you. Thank you for watching this very special yard of the week, or in this case, yards of the week, as we have done several today. Catching me up from my vacation, if you can call it a vacation. It's actually our family event. Getting me caught up from our family event. Oh man, thank you for watching and have a good one. We'll see you next time. Maybe it'll be back to normal. Maybe not, but we'll see.